please do.
Good morning. Welcome to the Treasure Coast Unitarian. Karina and I thought we might have some taller people today. That might work. Well, thank you, Jackie, for the music and for the help. My name is Janet Groat, and I want to welcome you to the Treasure Coast Unitarian Universalist Congregation here in Stuart, Florida. Today is May the 8th. I don't know if I'm looking in the right direction for YouTube. I'm not, but I'm here for all of you. visitors, if you are comfortable, please step up to the mic here and introduce yourself. Do you have any visitors that
We're getting the back view.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Allison, and I'm pleased to be here.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Jane. I'm Betty O'Brien's daughter, and happy to be here today.
Feel like a movie star walking around. Okay.
We need a front view, Karina. There you go.
Great. Oh, I hope I'm not going to knock over the chalice. Believe it or not, we got here real early to work on this stuff. announcements. Coming up on the 22nd, we're going to have Tia Breeding telling us a little bit about her time in Okinawa. That is part of our fourth Sunday event after the service. And of course, our park event is every first and third Tuesday, and also the fifth, if there is one. Not this week, okay. Not on the 5th anymore. Oh, okay. Tuesday at Stewart's Veterans Memorial Park downtown for at noon for a brown bag lunch. We really have a good time. And thanks to those who helped us with the service today, our greeters and our ushers, our techies, Corona Poloni and Chris McGann. Joanne Leone and Janet Rader for our coffee and cookies on the patio. And it is wonderful to see all our vaccinated and still mass members in the sanctuary. We are on YouTube also. To be put on our mail list or find out more information, go to our website at tcuuc.org. and note the email link to request an online newsletter. And for those visitors, if you haven't already filled out the form so you can get on our Friday email, make sure you do that before you leave. Reverend Faerie Elaine Silver will be in our pulpit today. Elaine is a seasoned performer, songwriter, touring musician, and recording artist. She is a licensed science of the mind practitioner. She combines her music with metaphysical teachings. Her musical ministry teaches universal law and truth principles in a way to fully engage the audience in a context of peace, love, joy, and wisdom. Elaine will be lighting our chalice. For the gift of this day, and for our community of spiritual nurture and compassion, we give thanks. We light this chalice as a symbol of our faith. May our many sparks meet and merge in the communion of heart and soul. Anya Samler Michael says, "I put my faith in you. I put my faith in every one of you who woke up this morning with the weight of loss, manifesting as numbness, anger, fear, or an aching pain. I put my faith in you. I pray you will put your faith in me. We need one another now, because we will not make it alone." And I say, I fear I have lost my faith, that faith in humanity. I've certainly lost my political faith. How could this come to be? Give me faith. Give me faith in our country. Give me those good vibrations. Now we'll do our affirmation. First, we'll recite it, and we'll then sing the second verse, and Elaine is going to help us with the singing. Love is the spirit of this church and services its law. This is our great covenant, to dwell together in peace, to seek the truth in love, and to help one another.
Okay.
From all that dwell beneath the skies, let faith and hope and love arise. Let beauty, peace, goodwood be sung from every land and every tongue.
It is time for joys and sorrows. I'm going to move the microphone down, but come up and tell us your name first, and move a stone in our symbolic river to mark each joy and sorrow. Of course, you can hear Reverend Bob saying, "Please keep it brief and personal."
My name is Geraldine Falk, and I want to put a stone in the river. Today is the anniversary of my father's death.
My name is Pam Corbin. I'm here in the mic because I'm grateful for a number of things, and happy Mother's Day if you're a mother or acted as a mother. For those of you who came to Brown Bag Lunch, including a first timer, I'd like to say thank you. Brown Bag Lunch is an act of fellowship. We really enjoy one another, and we just have to talk to one another. Jackie brought me a camera for the Dreyfus School. Thank you, Jackie. And people that can't come to Brown Bag Lunch, they make special efforts. People have jobs. Jackie came to Brown Bag Lunch last time, and it was so good to see her. We did do Lahaya. Three of us worked on Lahaya, and I want to let you know that they're understaffed. And it was a joy for us to make meal. I even bought a membership at Sam's Club. At the fourth thing is a thing of great concern to me. I don't know whether you know this man's name, but his name is Kevin Samuels. He died about 4 days ago, and he was a relationship counselor in the Black community, highly controversial. I'm glad my church tells me, use your head, check the background of people, you don't have to love everybody. And I give you his name. I ask you to look him up whenever you have a moment, because this person called me and anybody above the age of 40 and unmarried leftovers. That we were leftovers, and he was found dead in his hotel room. Look it up.
I love leftovers.
Yes.
Could have spelled it. Put four spells in.
Yes, thank you.
Four.
I put it on the nine.
It's over, so you don't have to. Hello, I'm Fred Dembowski. That's my lovely wife of 34 years. 34 years yesterday. And I have a joy. Well, first of all, I have a sorrow. We're not going to be here next Sunday because we're going up to Syracuse for my mother's memorial. She died of COVID 2.5 years ago, and we're finally having a service for her. For my oldest cousin, who just died last year, and for my granddaughter, Haven, who was turning 17, all Friday and Saturday. And finally, I'd like to say that I have a joy. Ronnie never apologizes. She never says she's sorry. But this morning, she told me that she was sorry that she ever met me.
Shall I move the stone back? Is there anyone else for joys and sorrows? I'll move a stone for those who have joys or sorrows that are too private to share. Now, Reverend Faerie, Elaine Silver.
So I was invited to share some haiku poetry. I caught the bug late September, and I have hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of them. It's like I can't stop. So I have five here, and these are haiku for Mother's Day. So the first one is, does everybody know? I'll just explain it very briefly. It's three lines. The first line has five syllables, the second line has seven syllables, and the third line has five syllables. And as a songwriter, I've developed a skill of making things fit, figuring out how many beats I have. And so it's really helpful for both. Being a songwriter and a haiku poet now has been very helpful for both of those. So here they go. Mother's Day is here. As I remember the love of my awesome mom. Her dad named her Tops, which meant the top shelf, and then Tops became Grandma. She never wanted to be called Granny or Grandma. She wanted a different name, so she ended up with her childhood nickname. I've no human kids, but I am a cat mommy. I nurture my girls. And most recent cat I got, I named her Cutie Pie. So she's mentioned here. The doppelganger of my kitty Cutie Pie showed up in the park. And then the final one is, instead of me telling you we're gonna do Spirit of Life, and you know the word, okay. The hymn, 1, 2, 3, is Spirit of Life. Let's sing. You all know the words. Are we ready? Oh, we gotta wait. Oh, okay. Okay. Let's see. We're gonna hum first, right?
That's right. I'm sorry. I fingerpicked this. Here we go.
Generous in spirit and in action. We now take an offering that allows us to exercise that all-important generosity of spirit, an offering that will support this congregation.
This is a tune I'd like to play. It's called Songs My Mother Taught Me. It's by Anton Dvorak.
Thank you, Jackie, and thank you all for the offering. It's gratefully received. Now for the main event.
Good morning, everybody. It's really nice to be back here. I drove over from Sarasota this morning, so I get up early, so it was kind of, and it didn't take me that long because there was no traffic. So I just want to say happy Mother's Day, and I want to see a show of hands. Who here is a mother?
What?
Okay, and now who here had a mother or has a mother? All of us, right? So we all can celebrate being a mom and having a mom. And you know, we have our mothers, we have our grandmothers, we have the people of the past, we have future mothers too. We just celebrate this continual gift of spirit. It continues to give. It's like spirit, Mother Nature, that's what it does. It's the gift of life. It's the law of life. It continues to give and give and give, and then we get to receive it. And then when we share that, what we get, we create more. We create into the law of circulation. You know, you give, receive, receive, give. It's all the same energy of sharing. But you don't want to stop the flow. So I wanted to also let you know that we're going to be honoring the goddess today, which is the feminine aspect of God. And I like to call that sometimes God, goddess, all that is. Because that power, that energy, that source really is everything, and everything that exists in the formed and the formless are manifestations of that one power and one presence. And then, of course, we have Mother Earth, our planet, our home, who continues to feed and nurture us through her nature, Mother Nature. The song is called Mother, Mother Nature, and I'm going to be honoring the four elements, which are also in line with the four directions and even the four seasons. So I'm putting my little priestess hat on for this song. Mother, Mother Nature, you are the ground we walk upon. Mother, Mother Nature, you are the air we breathe. Mother, Mother Nature, your fire warms my heart and soul. Mother, Mother Nature, your waters bring me peace. Mother Nature brings me peace. It's up to us to build the will. Communication is the skill. Cooperation brings goodwill. Let's keep the earth fulfilled. Mother, Mother Nature, you are the ground we walk upon. Mother, Mother Nature, you are the air we breathe. Mother, Mother Nature, your fire warms my heart and soul. Mother, Mother Nature, your waters bring me peace. We are microcosms of the planet Earth. Deep within our essence is our sacred worth. We are microcosms of the universe, and spirit brings us peace. If you want to join me? Mother, Mother Nature, you are the ground. You are the ground we walk upon. Mother, Mother Nature, you are the air. You are the air we breathe. Mother, Mother Nature, your fire. Your fire warms my heart and soul. Mother, Mother Nature, your waters. Your waters bring me peace. Bring me peace, bring me peace, bring me peace. Mother Nature brings us peace. Thank you for singing with me. Okay, and we can pretend it's a concert and it's okay to clap. Beautiful. So I have a couple just very short chants that honor the mother and the goddess. And the first one was written by Michael Stillwater, and the second one was written by me. We have the heart of the mother, and then one called Goddess Guide Us. So it goes like this. I am one with the heart of the mother. I am one with the heart of love. I am one with the heart of the goddess. I am one with God. Let's try that together. I am one. I am one with the heart of the mother love. I am one with the heart of love. I am one with the heart of the goddess. I am one with God. One more time. I am one with the heart of the mother. I am one with the heart of love. I am one with the heart of the goddess. I am one with God. Goddess, guide us. Mother, we are open, we believe. Mother, we are grateful, we receive. Is that law of circulation? Let's try that. Mother, we are open, we believe. Mother, we are grateful, we receive.
Mother, we are open, we believe.
Grateful.
Mother, we are grateful, we receive. Miracles of the earth called from deep inside us. Infinite universe, the goddess is our guide.
Let's try that chorus again.
Mother, we are open, we believe. Mother, we are grateful, we receive. Miracles of the earth called from deep inside us. Infinite universe, the goddess is our guide.
Goddess, guide us.
Goddess, guide us. Goddess guides us. Goddess guides us. Goddess guide us. Mother, we are open, we believe. Mother, we are grateful, we receive. Miracles of the earth called from deep inside us. Infinite universe, the goddess is our guide. The goddess is our guide. The goddess is our guide.
You know, I have, over the years, had many adopted moms. You know, I just make everybody my family. It's so much fun to do that. And I've had a number of women who have, we've become, you know, adopted mom and daughter for fun, really. And the first time this happened was in the late 90s. And there's a woman, she left the planet. She left in 2014, but for those number of years, we were spiritual mother and daughter, and her name was Delaine Lipka, and she was from the Bronx originally, but she moved to Flemington, New Jersey, and married her husband basically to get out of the house when she was 16, and so and then when she was 18, she had her first daughter, I'm the second one, but and. Her first child and her second child were they were within 12 months, so they were Irish twins, right? And so I'm within that time frame too. So she had Irish triplets. That means, you know, born within 1 year. So she also owned a beautiful retreat in Washington, New Jersey. There's seven Washington, New Jerseys, by the way, but this is the one that is about 9 miles east of Easton, Pennsylvania, by Phillipsburg, by Route 78, 22, if you know the area. 189-acre mountaintop. And I met her in 1993. She had started hosting this magnificent affair called the Kindred Spirits Fair. And it was like hippie heaven for a couple of days in the end of May. After the first one, I just couldn't leave. I just stayed, and then I got on board and was, you know, in charge of whatever, the sound and promoting the Kindred Spirits Fair. But Delaine and I got closer, and then a few years later, we adopted each other. And she even moved to Sarasota in the winters, where I live. So I got to see her a lot in the winter and stay with her in the summer. And she was very positive. She was very wise and very generous with her time and her space. And she used to say, this was how she sounded, "Enjoy every moment." So I'm thinking, like, enjoy every moment. That, you know, every is an absolute. Well, there are no absolutes, or there are very few. So I'm like, how can you enjoy every moment? That sounds like a lie. So I just had this judgment about enjoy every moment. And but then some of us started saying it. We'd say, enjoy every moment. Oh, it would just make us feel good. It's just that word joy and enjoy in every moment. It just brought us, you know, first maybe we were kind of making fun of her, but then it started to, and then we would go, EEM, enjoy every moment. And so I was on tour, you know, I was going on tour for like three and a half to 4 months every summer. And I was with her. We decided to have one kind of, we stopped having the fair, but we had one little thing on Labor Day 2014. Let's just do one more. And so that was the only day I could do it. So we called it a Labor Day of Love. It was like a mini Kindred Spirits Fair. And people are saying, she's going next year. But she was really fading. And she was like walking around with her walker. And she was fading. But and I left the next day. I had to get back to Florida. And my last memory of her was that she was so happy and so looking forward to the future. And then on the 14th, you know, she was Jewish, so she died at sundown on Friday, September 14th, which was kind of apropos. Was interesting. And I had just gotten home. I knew that she had something happened that morning, and that she was in the hospital. I got home, it was when we lived in West Palm, and I was home for 15 minutes. I get the phone call. She passed. Oh my God! So they held the funeral for me, so I'm the next day. I'm on an airplane going back, and the song came out. Enjoy every moment. I'm going to teach you the chorus. It goes like this: Enjoy every moment. Enjoy your life. When you enjoy every moment, you shine your light. Let's try that part. Enjoy every moment, enjoy your life. Enjoy your life when you enjoy. When you enjoy every moment, you shine your light. You shine your light. Enjoy. Enjoy every moment, enjoy what's here. Enjoy what's here when you enjoy. When you enjoy every moment, the truth is clear. The truth is clear. The love of God is blessing you. The light of the goddess protects. The power of the goddess is watching, and her presence redirects you to enjoy every moment. Your life, enjoy your life. When you enjoy every moment, you shine your light. Delaine loved to laugh, and she loved hugs. When she first met my husband, when he was my boyfriend, and she met him, the next morning, she says, "I love James." I said, "I know, he's great, isn't he?" She goes, "No, I mean, I love him as much as I love you." I'm like, "What?" She says, "I could tell by his hug." She was a hugger. She knew that he was a good hugger. So here's that verse. Life is good and getting better, and laughing seals the deal. Ha ha ha. Reach out now to one another with hugs that help you heal, and enjoy every moment. Enjoy your life. When you enjoy every moment, you shine your light. Enjoy every moment. Enjoy what's here. When you enjoy every moment, the truth is clear. My Jewish mom, Delaine's now gone, but these were her wise words. I share them now with peace and love, and I know that you've heard. To enjoy every moment. Enjoy your life. When you enjoy every moment, you shine your light. When you enjoy every moment, you shine your light.
There you go. No, she was not only my adopted mom. She was such a good friend. She was my friend. She was wise. She was my confidant. And sometimes I would go to her and cry on her shoulder. And I did that this one year. She says to me, "Adapt and adjust." That's pretty good. Adapt and adjust. Yeah, I got that. You know, because eventually you're going to have to accept it. If you don't, you're going to suffer. All suffering is when we don't accept what is, when we want what is to be different from how it is. So adapt and adjust. So a few years later, something really, really sad happened to her. It was with one of her other children, and she was crying. She was really upset, and it was at Mount Eden. It was the summer. And so I used to make her coffee every morning. So she came downstairs and had the coffee, and she loved that. She came and I said, "How are you?" Yeah. She says to me, "I'm just gonna have to adapt and adjust." She took her own advice. I love that about her. You know, because I, for some reason, you know, I had never heard her say that again, but yes, I'm just going to have to adapt and adjust. So here's the song. Adapt and adjust, adjust and adapt. Acceptance is the key. Adapt and adjust, adjust and adapt. Acceptance for you and me. God grants me the serenity and courage to make a change. God grants me the wisdom to know when to play that game. Come on, adapt and adjust. Adapt and adjust, adjust and adapt. Acceptance is the key. Adapt and adjust and adapt. Acceptance for you and me. Adapt and adjust and adapt. Acceptance is the key. Acceptance. Acceptance is the key. One more. Acceptance is the key. Good job. All right, so now we're going to talk about my mom, who we call Tops. You know, once she took on that name when her first grandchild, Amanda Marie. We all have Marie as our middle name. For the Blessed Mother, there's another mom.
So when I was 6 years old, my mom got pregnant. And so they were expecting our fifth child. And my mother found out that her due date was St. Patrick's Day. And as a good Catholic woman, she felt obligated, right? That if the baby was born on St. Patrick's Day, she was going to name him or her Patrick or Patricia. And this was in 1961. And they didn't know, you couldn't tell the sex at that point beforehand. St. Patrick's Day, 1961 comes. My mother goes into labor and she's going out the door. She's praying to God that she has the baby tomorrow. Well, we got Gretchen. And she was here once. She was here last time I was here. My sister Gretchen was here. And that was really a really cool thing, you know, that to have my sister. And she's also my doctor. So this was February 13th, 2018. And James and I are still living in West Palm Beach. And he was getting ready to retire, and we were going to move back to Sarasota. He worked over here, he retired as an engineer working with NASA at Pratt & Whitney. Very proud of him. But we were always homesteaded in Sarasota, so we moved back in June. But this was February 13th, and I had a woman, Diana, who used to work for me. She would do data entry for me, and she told me, there's a cat, and she's living on our patio, and I think she's pregnant. And so I was like, And I knew that Diana and her husband had four cats already, and they lived in a small duplex, and they just couldn't take on another cat, even though they loved this kitty. She named her Princess. Well, I took her. I went over there. I said, oh, maybe I'll get a kitten. When I get there, and there's this gorgeous, like, medium long hair, Himalayan, with white paws, I call them snowshoes, and blue eyes, and this beautiful coloring. And I was like, I'm taking this one. Forget about the baby, but eventually we got three. So here we are, and so I know what happened. I took this cat, who she named Princess, to the vet, and the vet said, yes, she's healthy, yes, she's pregnant, and she's about a year old. How do you know how old this cat is? Well, they can tell by the tartar on the teeth. You know, there's ways they can tell. So I thought about the birthdays, and we have different, like, holiday birthdays and the same birthdays and half birthdays in our family. We have this thing with birthdays. So I thought, okay, well, my niece, who made me great, she had a baby on Valentine's Day in 2017. So I thought, okay, well, we're going to make this cat and her cousin have the same birthday. So this future mama cat was born on Valentine's Day 2017. And so then I brought her home, and she's getting bigger and bigger, and she didn't have the babies yet. I thought she was going to have them in a couple of weeks because she was pretty big. But guess what day she had the babies? St. Patrick's Day. Right? So, in order really to honor my mom, you know, when it was imminent that she was having these babies in the middle of the night on St. Patrick's Day, and to honor her, I decided, well, we're going to give them Irish names. And we got three. And so St. Patrick's Day, it's almost the springtime, but it's at the very end of winter. And this particular year, 2018, do you remember that we had two blue moons that year? There were two blue moons, and you can only have two blue moons in a year if it's in January and March, because then there's no full moon at all in February. It's really an interesting thing. It happens more often than I had originally thought. It's same thing with the new moons. I wrote a little song called Three Little Kittens, and to honor my mom and to honor the mother love of a new mama cat. And how did she know how to do all that stuff? She was a great mommy cat. Great. And she knew what to do. So it was a very magical time, you know, for something, anything to occur in between two blue moons. That's magical. And because it's rare, this was a very rare time. So I made this little song called Three Little Kittens, and it goes, born between two blue moons, just before the spring. Born between two blue moons, such a magical thing. Three little kittens newly born on St. Patrick's Day. Three little babies newly formed. Blessings keep coming our way. And it really was a blessing to have these babies. It really helped our marriage. It was quite wonderful. Born between two blue moons, just before the spring. Born between two blue moons, such a magical thing. Three little kittens came to us on this Irish day. Aaron and Patrick too, then Danny boy came our way. Born between two blue moons, just before the spring. Born between two blue moons, such a magical thing. Precious angels, mother love, the presence of the flow. Precious mother gives her all. This essence makes us all grow. One more time. Born between two blue moons, just before the spring. Born between two blue moons, such a magical thing. Such a magical thing. Such a magical thing. Have a little thank you. And there's an epilogue to the story, because we got the three, and Erin, who's a little gray girl, a little tiny thing, she wasn't interested in eating. And then we got Patrick, and we got Danny boy. And so my husband wanted to keep them all, but I was like, we can't keep them all. So I was committed to finding a home for the two boys, the same home, so they could stay together. And I wanted it to be not too far from Sarasota, so that we could have visitation rights. and it happened to be Mother's Day 2018, and I was doing a program at a Unity Church in Brandon. And so I'm talking about I did this song, I'd written this song for that program, and this woman, Marilyn, came up to me. She says, I'll take one of the kittens, because my husband died in the fall, and I wanted to get a dog, but my kids said a cat's much easier. So I said, well, you have to take them both. And so she took them both. And so we have Cat Mommy Marilyn, and the kittens got a new home on Mother's Day. So we have Valentine's Day, St. Patrick's Day, Mother's Day. So even more to celebrate that, we have the holiday cat family, and we have visited them a number of times, and it's wonderful. I'm going to do one more song. This is a Beatles song, and it was written by Paul, and you know, it was towards the end of the Beatles when it was a volatile time for them all, but Paul in particular, because he was really the most musically committed. He was a little bit like a drill sergeant, especially at the end, like making sure, do it again. So it meant the most to him, I think, really, because they'd been together 10 years, and yeah, it was time, you know, for them to have their own lives. And so during this tumultuous time, Paul had a dream, and his mother appeared to him in the dream. And he hadn't seen her in a long time because when he was about 16 or 15, she had succumbed to breast cancer, just like his wife, Linda. She died of breast cancer. And not long after that, John lost his mom, Julia, and that was another thing that really bonded these two motherless boys. So in the dream, his mother said, you know, like basically, it'll be okay, allow it, da-da-da, but the words that she said were, let it be. And when I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me. That was his mom's name, Mary. So a lot of people, even churches sing this, they think it's about, you know, the Blessed Mother, which I'm sure Mary McCartney was a Blessed Mother. As we're all blessed. So this will be the last song for the program, and thank you so much. It was wonderful working with Janet, and I loved your cello playing. It's beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And if you know it, please join in.
When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be. Whisper words of wisdom, let it be. And when the broken-hearted people living in the world agree, there will be an answer, let it be. For though they may be parted, there is still a chance that they will see. There will be an answer, let it be. Let it be, let it be. Let it be, there will be an answer, let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be, yeah, let it be. Whisper words of wisdom, let it be. And when the night is cloudy, there is still a light that shines on me. Shine until tomorrow, let it be. I wake up to the sound of music. Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Let it be, let it be, let it be, yeah, let it be. There will be an answer, let it be. Let it be, let it be, let it be, yeah, let it be. Whisper words of wisdom, let it be.
May the goddess bless each and every one of us. Thank you again.
Ah, let it be. As we have listened to the blessing of music, may the warmth of this community and the memory of our chalice flame sustain our hearts and encourage our minds as we engage the blessings of life's challenges and joys. Go now in peace. Go now in joy. Go now in love. After the postlude, we will have coffee and cookies on the patio. Thank you.
Mother's Day.